Hello, my lovely people. Welcome to my channel. So today I wanted to share with you these extremely flavorful recipes that you can do for the holidays. You are going to absolutely love. They are very easy to do, yet extremely flavorful. Okay, you know I'm all about flavor. So enjoy this Christmas vlog that I have done for you guys. Sit back, relax, grab a glass of wine. Enjoy the show, you are going to love.
Merry Christmas!
It's
very good, actually. It looks very bueno.
It looks kind of better on the camera.
Yeah.
Merry Christmas 2022. Welcome to my channel. I wanted to share with you two recipes today that you are going to absolutely love. They are quick and easy. Well, the cooking time is not quick, however it is quick, it's really quick to do, and it's super easy, and most of all it's very tasty. Okay, it's gonna be so flavorful. Like always, you know I love flavorful, I love flavor, so I show you how to add flavor into your food. So today we are going to be making chicken. Okay, so we are going to be baking our chicken. Okay, so you just cook it everywhere. The reason why we are poking the chicken is simply so that the ingredients, once we put everything, once we season the chicken, it's going to penetrate in the chicken, okay? Bringing so much flavor. I'll do the same thing with the other one. All right, so we are going to be moving on to the next step, which is putting our seasoning. Okay, so it's very simple, like I've said, it's absolutely simple. So we are going to be putting the ingredient, my main ingredients. Okay, these are the ingredients I always cook with, and I'm going to show you, you know. By now you're already familiar with my ingredients, okay? So I'm just going to be adding something a little bit different to the chicken today. So, but what I'm going to be needing are 2 green onions, okay? Ginger root, celery, about 6 ounces of tomato sauce, okay? 6 ounces of tomato sauce, and about 1/4 size of a red onion, okay? And we're gonna put a little bit of nutmeg, a little bit of bell peppers, I'll show you here in a minute. And of course, garlic, okay? You have to have garlic, okay? Very important. Okay, so we are going to be putting about two garlics in a blender, okay? We are going to be blending everything. All right, guys, so let me go ahead and grab my blender so we can be blending the chicken, okay? So we are going to be blending with my favorite blender, even though I hate the noise that the blender makes, but this is the best. I have 3 different ones. I have the big one, and this one I usually use for food, and then I have another one I use for smoothies and drinks. Okay, so putting a green onion, celery, oh my gosh, 2 green onions, okay, and ginger root, okay, and onion, okay, but we have to divide it. We cannot put the entire onion. It's going to be way too much flavor, and we don't want that, okay? We want the perfect flavor, but not too much, okay? So I have to divide it. Okay, so I'm going to divide it by two. And this is a very large, this is a very, very large onion, okay? Divide it by two, and then I'm going to again divide the half of it. Okay, so it's like a large onion divided by four. Okay, so this is how much, you know, we need. This is how much onion we need to put in the blender. Okay, so what do I have here? I'm going to remind you again. I have garlic. Did I put garlic? Not yet. This is why you have to repeat yourself so you can remember. Two garlics, okay? So we have garlic, we have onion, we have green onion, we have celery, we have what else? That's it, and we are going to go ahead and blend. I'm not gonna bring you to the blender today. I'm just gonna go ahead and blend it, and then I'll be back. Okay. All right, so this is blended. This is what I have blended. So we are going to be repeating the same step for the other chicken because we have two chickens. So it's going to be the same exact portions, okay? Use the same exact so your two chickens can have the same flavor, okay? So what I'm going to be adding to this is salt, okay? I'm going to be adding 1 tablespoon of salt. And you can taste it a little bit to see if that's okay, okay? If not, then you can add a little bit more, okay? So this is for my one chicken, okay? So I'm going to be adding, you okay?
Yeah.
Okay. I'm going to be adding salt to it, but I'm not going to put it here because I'll do the, you know, I'm going to make more for the other chicken. I don't know if that makes sense to you. You can use maybe a cup. I think it'll be better. So sometimes what I do, I'll just pour it on the chicken and then add, and then I'm gonna mix it up later, okay? So, and we have to do it quick, okay, so that everything can be mixing together. Okay, so I'm going to be repeating the same step for the other chicken, but I'm not going to show you because I've showed you already what I have done. So I'm going to go ahead and do it, and then we are going to be mixing everything together. So this is the other mixture, okay? So I'm going to be putting it in the other chicken, okay? Just like that, okay? So, and then we are going to be grabbing our nutmeg, okay? And we are going to sprinkle a little bit on both. Ooh, the onions are burning my eyes. It's crazy. I want to cry right now.
You're crying.
Yeah, onions are kicking my ass. Excuse my language. The onions are kicking my behind. Okay, sorry about that. And we are going to be adding tomato sauce, okay? Oh, this is from the can. This is just tomato sauce from a can. And I'm going to be adding, kind of dividing it into two. You know, in your mind, just trying to divide it. This is about 6 ounces, okay? So we're gonna put 3 ounces each, okay? Woo, onions, okay. We are going to be mixing everything together, and make sure you let all of your ingredients penetrate the chickens, okay? So we are going to mix it real good, okay? And make sure you wash your hands because it's a little messy. I don't like that part, this part, but it has to be done. Okay. Thank you. and just make sure you put it all around inside the chicken, okay? Inside and everything, okay? We have to make sure the ingredients are going in, okay? And the reason why I have used red onion is simply because red onions has more flavor, or yeah, the red onion has more flavor than the white ones. So, but you can use any onion, really. But I like the red onion when I'm making this recipe right here. And it hurts, like it's, I have dry skin right now. And the ingredients are killing me right now. Like, I want to cry. I really want to cry right now. It hurts, okay? Oh my gosh. This is not fun.
All right, so after I had mixed all of the ingredients really good into the chickens, I'm going to let them sit for about 1 hour, and then I'm going to bring it into the oven to bake at 350 degrees. Okay, so 350 degrees, and it takes about 40 to 45 minutes.
Right, so I have my oven at 350 degrees, and we are going to be placing this inside. Okay, so just like that, and we are going to let it bake for about 40 minutes or until you feel that it's ready.
All right. I am cooking also, so I'm making some cassava leaves, okay? This is an African dish.
I'm not sharing the recipes, but I just wanted to make sure I show you that I'm also making cassava leaves, okay? You are going to see it when I set up the table, okay? Cassava leaves, oh my gosh, it's so good, okay? If you've never tried it, honey, you are missing out. It's super, super yummy. All right, guys. So the other recipe that I have for you that is quick and easy is going to be beef stew. And we are going to put it in the oven as well. So this is real, real simple. All I'm going to do is cut it off, okay? Cut this off in small pieces. And I'm going to be putting my ingredients. And I don't have a lot. I have half of a large onion, and I have half of a bell pepper here, okay? And then I have two garlics, and so I have roast beef, okay? I forgot how many pounds, but this is what it looks like, okay? So this is what I'm going to have. I'm going to be cutting in small pieces, and of course we are going to have some salt and a little bit of nutmeg, and that will be it. So simple, easy, but very, very flavorful.
All right, so now that I have all of my ingredients in the blender, I'm going to go ahead, blend everything together, and then I'm going to be putting it in the meat, okay? But first I have to have the meat in very small chunks, okay? The smaller you have it, the better the ingredients are going to go in. So as you can see, the way I'm cutting it, so it's not very big nor super small. All right, so now that I'm done blending, look at the beautiful color, okay? This looks like this bright yellow because of the bell peppers, okay? So I'm going to go ahead and, you know, pour it in the meat, and I have salt, okay? I put a little bit of salt. Be careful with the salt. If you do too much, you are going to have something that's going to be tasting so awful. Okay, very, very awful. So I just put a little bit of salt, and I have my ingredients, and I'm just gonna make sure I mix them very good together. And this time I'm using a spatula, spoon, whatever, like you know what I'm using, because my hands, they are burning, okay? Because of my dry skin, it's really, really bad. All right. You see the way this looks? Just like that. So everything has been evenly spread out. So we are going to also let it sit for about an hour. You know, you don't necessarily have to. Even if you put in the oven now, you'll be fine. But 1 hour just to be sure. Okay, and then we are going to bring it in the oven. And again, we are going to let it cook for about 40 minutes. Now, I wanted to share with you the way I do my potatoes sometimes. So what I have here is, what I have done is inside the pot, I have salt and water. So I have diluted salt, quite a bit of salt, you know, not too much, but significant, okay? So you can taste the salt. I have diluted the salt in the water. So what I'm going to do is I'm peeling my potatoes, and I'm going to have them in small pieces, and then I'm going to put them inside the salty water for about 3 hours. Okay, so what it's doing, it's going to let the salt penetrate into the potatoes. So once you fry your potatoes, you are tasting this really yummy, salty flavor, okay? Not too much salt, but it's just going to be, it's like the potato is naturally salted. Exactly, that's what we're going for. But it's because I'm putting it inside the salty water, okay? So just like that, you see that? So that water you see is salted, you know, has quite a bit of salt, and I'm just gonna dip my potatoes inside, and I'm just gonna let them sit for about 3 hours, and it's going to be super flavorful once I fry those potatoes. So I don't know about you guys, but me, the fastest way for me to peel my potatoes, I have to do it with a knife. I cannot do it with a potato peeler to save my life. I cannot. I'm just never able to. So I use a knife. It's very practical for me. And it's faster. It's easiest. It's the easiest way. I don't know why. Every time my sister comes to my house, she's like, how come you use a knife? This is easy for me. So I'm going to do what's easy for me. Okay. All right, so now I have my potatoes in the salted water, and I'm going to let them sit for about 3 hours. And once I fry my potatoes, they are going to have this natural salt, and it's so good. You know what I mean? It's super, super good, and I love it. All right, look how beautiful and how tasty this looks. So this is our beef after it has been cooked for about 40 minutes. It's so juicy and so flavorful. When I tell you flavorful, oh boy. And did you see how easy this was? Simple and easy, yet super flavorful. So now, this is after 3 hours. Now I'm going to deep fry my potatoes. And once they're done, this is simple, okay? So we're just making plain potatoes, but we're still adding a bit of flavor to it so that we can enjoy. So very easy, just dip it in salty water and go ahead and fry, okay? So they are ready and simple, quick and easy. Okay, you just fry them, deep fry them, and they're ready to be enjoyed. Okay, so next, let me go ahead and show you our chicken. So the chicken is done, and this is, oh my goodness. I mean, can you see how juicy this is? And I had put bell peppers all around and on top just to add extra flavor. This is super good, okay? And this is the beef. Again, this is my table. I have it set up very quick and easy and not too much. So we are getting ready to enjoy Christmas with family, because family time is super priceless, guys.
So guys, as far as our recipes, we are done. However, you are welcome to stay and see how we had spent our Christmas with family. We haven't played games this time, but what we have done is we had a singing competition. We had a singing competition, and whoever wins, was to get $120,000 minus three zeros. Ha, psych! I wish, but yeah, $130. In fact, $130. And these are my kids, my daughter, my son, and that was my husband laying on the couch, just a relaxing Christmas day. I wanted to give them. This is my son, my firstborn. Oh, I love them so much. I love my family, and I thank God every day for them. This is how I have my little table set up. I didn't want to do too much for my food presentation, so I just had a little bit of bottles, lighting bottles or lantern bottles, you know, those bottles with lights inside. Those bottles, these are bottles that we have used. I washed them, I cleaned them, and I put lights inside. And this is how I have my forks, my utensils, okay, my forks, spoons, and knives inside the dispenser. It's easier that way, and it's fancy. I love it. That's my daughter, okay, my one and only. She's about to present you the food.
Yes, you'll do it too. You'll do it too.
We got those.
Some potatoes. Yeah.
In case you're vegan. Now this one, rice. People and are going to eat this all up.
Yeah, we have more.
Me too.
So this is just for the table, and we have more.
We
definitely have more. That's cassava leaves.
Cassava leaves?
Yes.
I'm not copying that. Yeah. Some
chicken.
We have some potatoes. And we have some yellow rice.
Yeah, there you go. Woo! Sexy mama! Sexualization! Sexifization! Mamaization! Yeah? Food as is. About to do a singing competition. Whoever wins gets $120,000. Minus the three zeros.
Yes.
Okay. Singing competition. Je t'ai voulu la guerre, dans toutes les qui se fait la paix. Je sais.
You better be good.
that's Michelle's present. This is for what's the name? What's the name here?
Priska.
This is for Auntie Priska. This is Auntie Priska's present. Woo! Come on, guys, help me out. Pick up the presents and read the names. This is for Uncle Vinny. Where's Uncle Vinny? Uncle Vinny, this is yours. Uncle Vinny.
Okay, what's my prize?
Okay. Okay, whose present is this? Auntie, no, put it back. They're not here. Yeah, this one, put it back.
How about my present?
Yeah, so let's read the names. Let me see. What's this one? What is this? This is for Given. This is for Given.
A second.
Given. Let me see. This is for Sonnet. This is for Sonnet. This is for Sonnet. Yeah, that's for, is it yours?
Yeah.
This is for Blaze. Yeah, Blaze.
What about?
Huh?
Yours is the gold one with no name.
Yes, I'll get it in a moment.
Where's Daniel?
Let me see whose present is this. You gotta read the names. What's the name on this one?
No name.
No name, so that means it's for someone else. Okay. Let me see. Oh, this is for Auntie Bennett. She's not here yet. This is for... This is for Auntie Jamie. Merry Christmas.
Thank you.
You're welcome. You're welcome. This is for you, Alan. That's your present. That's for you. You can open it.
Really?
Yeah, that's yours.
Didn't get one.
Who? Daniel got one. He got one. We just gotta find it. Hold on. This is for Danny. That's yours.
Yeah.
Yay!
No way! I get what it is.
Huh? No, so she's.